Okay, so today we'll be talking about the CHADSVASC score. When do we use the CHADSVASC score? Basically, this is a score that was developed to know whether a patient has a higher risk of having strokes in AFib or atrial flutter. They basically took a bunch of patients, you can say like 100,000 patients, and they have stratified them according to their risks. And then they followed them for a couple of years and they said, okay, it seems that the patient with the higher risks had more chance of getting a stroke every year. So they developed the score. But this score was not really CHADSVASC. We had a previous score which was called CHADS, which only had 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And according to that, you will say whether your patient was high risk or not. But the newer modified version is actually called CHADSVASC. Let's go through that really quickly. The C stands for CHF, heart failure. H stands for hypertension. A with a 2, you gotta remember that if your patient is above 75, he's gonna get 2 points. D, guess what? Diabetes. The S stands for stroke. And if your patient had a stroke or a TIA, then they will get 2 points. V stands for vascular disease. So if your patient has peripheral vascular disease, coronary artery disease, aortic, peripheral, any of that, they'll get a point. Now the second A, as you remember, we had an A that had 2 points, but this A actually means that if your patient is between 65 and 74, they will get 1 point. Above or equal 75, they'll get 2 points. And now the S at the end stands for, the S and a C, you can say, it stands for if your patient is a female, automatically she will get 1 point. So all of those, they get 1 point, except if you have a history of stroke, you'll get 2 points, or if your patient is above or equal 75 years of age, they will get 2 points each, but the rest will get 1 point. Now, things that, you know, you just have to think about. If you have a female and she is 76 years old, even without knowing what her medical comorbidities are, she's gonna get 2 points and 1 point. She's gonna get 3 points. By itself, according to the CHADSVASC, she needs anticoagulation. Just think about it. Now, how do I choose whether the patient needs anticoagulation or not? So, if their CHADSVASC is 0, do nothing and do not harm the patient. If a patient has a score of 1, recently they said aspirin would work. If the patient has 2 or more, then you will need anticoagulation. And basically we're talking about full anticoagulation. Your options are warfarin or any of those newer oral anticoagulants. If the patient is in the hospital, you give them heparin drip, or you can put them on Lovenox. And that's basically the CHADSVASC score. Whenever you get a question in your exam saying this patient has atrial fibrillation or atrial flutter, how can I prevent them from having a stroke? First, you have to ask yourself, what is their CHADSVASC score? 0, then do nothing. 1, you can give them aspirin, but if they have 2 or more points, then you will deem them for anticoagulation for the rest of their lives.